What's up, guys? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man, George.
Yeah. Shout out to the free thinkers. I'm gonna skip that real quick, man. This better be hot because we told y'all, man, when Dave dropped this album, we had two choices. It was this and Verdansk because those were just dominating our requests for songs on this particular album. And we said we chose Verdansk because that was a little bit shorter.
A lot shorter.
You know what I'm saying? So this is what, 9 minutes or so, something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
And but once we drop Verdansk, the overwhelming,
like, you gotta do it, man.
Majority of you guys
gotta do Heart Attack,
man. We need that Lost to Vegas Heart Attack. I'm telling you, so much better than Verdansk. It's what we love about Dave. It's the embodiment of what Dave is and what he's about, and yada yada yada. You guys were really, really, just really passionate about us doing this song. So the people cried out for this one, man. Said we needed to get to it, so we're getting to it. Mr. Dave.
Yeah, let's do it.
Heart Attack. Heartbeat, heart attack.
Knife crime is at a near record high, with more than 40 blade offences every day in London.
At a youth club in South London, not far from where someone was stabbed less than 24 hours ago, he outlined a direct link between violent crime, social exclusion, and austerity. A study by City Hall found that London has seen an increase of 71% in victims of serious youth violence since 2012. The mayor says this is linked to an increase in poverty, with the highest rates of violence taking place in some of the poorest boroughs.
This long ass song, man. We're going to make
it.
Our stops are going to be quick and be like, yep, cool, like that. Cook, back to it.
No, I know it's long. But, man, I didn't know that, though. I didn't know. They say that knife crimes is nearly at a record high in London. 40 blade offenses every day in London, yeah. Right? And I guess the mayor is saying it's because of the increased poverty. I know that every place has poverty, but I thought London was beautiful. Every time I see pictures in movies and shit on London, it looks beautiful. It looks like, you know, the structure and people look happy and it looks like it's just a thriving.
It is. And then there's the other side of it, just like every other major city, right? Go to Miami, up, cool. Then go outside of South Beach. What the fuck? Outside of the Vegas Strip, you're like, what the fuck?
That's true, yeah.
Go to Dubai, and you're like, ooh, Dubai. And then you don't realize.
Dubai ain't got no ghetto.
Shit. I'm going to send you. I wouldn't even call it ghetto. They just got these. Anyways, I'm going to send you the link to the immigrants and everything, the people that. It's a crazy
story. We have everybody from Dubai like, what?
Watch a video on YouTube. I think it's called the Dubai Fucking Sucks or some shit like
really?
That. Yeah, look that up on YouTube, and it'll tell you about Dubai, man.
Wow, you know,
not
okay.
That I'm trying to come at Dubai, but right. it's got a dark side to it. So it's poverty everywhere. Every major city.
I didn't mean to digress, but yeah, that was really shocking to me that it was that bad, though.
I bet them boys think I'm panicking. Check what my young G's are carrying. It's blade same length as a javelin. I don't know about B-ball, what's happening, but know that it's fucked if he's traveling and we see him. I can't lie, I was depressed at phases. I was 19 when the team nearly left him faceless, hoping that we never left no traces. You know when you're so damn tired in your house, but you can't sleep cause you got pending cases. I used to love tempting fate, but now it's tempting faces. For half my career, I was part of that. My best friend got a burner and it's looking like an artifact. Put it in your puffer or your Prada hat. Like, fuck panic, that's a heart attack.
No.
Yeah. It's like life's so fucked in the time that we're in. We're fighting the world and we're fighting within. Somali dad ran away from a war, now his son's in a war, that's the cycle we're in. Yeah. I know niggas that didn't do time in a bin that have never had freedom of mind. Are you sick?
Yeah,
round
yeah,
here,
yeah,
main
nah,
way
I
to
wanna,
provide
yeah,
for your kid is
a
flip blade, little push bike, and a sin.
Okay, speed round, boom. Gonna look like an artifact? Fire.
That is, because it is
relation,
an artifact.
It is an artifact, yeah. Right? In that area, man, yeah. Where guns are illegal, we like, you got a burner, where you get that from, bro?
Mm-hmm.
You don't see those around here. That shit looking like an artifact.
Yep.
So I really love that line, and I think it speaks to that scene. He went in right here when he said, I was 19 when the team nearly left him faceless, hoping that we left no traces. You know, when you're so damn tired in your house, but you can't sleep because you got pending cases.
Mm-hmm.
I used to love tempting fate, but now it's
tempting
faces. Fire. For half my career, I was part of that. So he's setting the table, man. Again, they talked about the knife crime.
Yep.
And he's just taking you back into his history when he was running with his young G's, man.
Yeah.
You know, tempting faces. You know what I mean? You know, buck 50 is what we call them. You know,
they got a blade like a javelin.
Like long as a javelin. So I love this, the background story that he's given us, man, and what he was involved in the street shit. You know, but, you know, when he said, but you can't sleep because you got pending cases, just the stress, the anxiety that comes with being in that world, man.
I used to love tempting fate, but now it's tempting faces. Like, you know, you're living life on the edge, right? You're tempting how, you know, far your fate, right?
Yeah.
You know? And it's hard. It's hard. I think it speaks to exactly what you were saying.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Yep. Somali dad ran away from a war. Now his son's in a war. That's the cycle that we're in. You know, so his father, I'm assuming he's a second generation. I don't know if his dad is Somalian or if he's Somalian or whatever the case may be, but he could be talking about something in general. You know, he left his home country to get away from an actual war, right? To provide a better life for his children, the Somali dad, or replace Somali dad with anyone, leaving, you know, war zones, right? To kind of create better lives for their family. And then now his kids, his offspring, are now getting involved in the streets in this area. So they're fighting their own wars, right? Their own knife crime and things like that. So it's like...
And fighting within each other.
Yeah, that's right.
Crazy.
And we're fighting within. Somali dad ran away from a war. Now his son's in a war. That's the cycle we're in. I know niggas that didn't do time in a bin that have never had freedom of mind. Are you sick? Round here, main way to provide for your kin is in a flip blade, little push bike and a sim. In London, a place where it's nicer to live is only 5 minutes out from the guys on the strip. Where man made yay work. Heard he a soldier. I know that nigga hasn't got balls like Grey Worm. As I grow older, change of perspective. I gotta stay loyal to my girl. That's the trait she was.
The Game of Thrones Grey Worm reference, though, man. he ain't got balls. You know, what did he say? He said, where is it at?
Balls like Grey Worm.
Where man can make yay work. Heard he a soldier. I know that dude hasn't got balls like Grey Worm. I know he not about that life. You know, I heard the dude was a soldier, but I don't think he's really about it, man. You know what I'm saying? But Grey Worm was a soldier from the Unsullied Army, if you watch Game of Thrones, you know what I'm saying? He was castrated. He didn't have balls. Also, this line, I know dudes that never did time in a bandit, but they never had freedom of mind. Are you sick? You know, so it's funny, like, you know, he's kind of making a connection that even though they're not locked down in jail, you know what I'm saying, in a situation where they're in four walls, their mind
is in a prison.
Right? You know what I'm saying? They're stuck in this perpetual violent lifestyle. They don't really know their way out. You know, they're just products of their environment.
And are you sick? Are you insane? Right? What's the definition of insanity?
Yeah.
Doing the same thing and expecting a different result.
That's right.
You know?
Really dope, man. Let's keep it going.
That nigga hasn't got balls like Grey Worm. As I grow older, change of perspective. I gotta stay loyal to my girl. That's the trait she was blessed with. Restaurants, raves with my brethren. Life's too short, so we gotta turn up. Man, talk on my ting for the gram is intrusive. I never really thought about taking a life till I found out my ex-girl's dad is abusive. I felt, how could I be a man and not do shit? I'm on the way there now and I don't wanna lose it. But fighting her battles only hurting a girl. How can I protect her from the world when I couldn't even protect her from myself on my grandmother's grave? Shit happens again, I put a knife through a family friend. Most of the women that I know had shit happened to them. So innocent till guilty ain't something that I have to respect. I think back to my youth and I was so ungrateful. How many of our parents had dreams they abandoned so they could put food on the table, intelligent, worthy and able to somebody's parent? You know?
Yeah,
and that affected
shit.
The way like that I see shit.
Yeah.
Nightclub toilet. You peed on the seat because you don't know how it feels when your mum's got to clean shit. And her boss treats her like she don't even mean shit. And she got to wait for the bus in the rain and it's freezing. The miss said that you won't ever be shit. And you don't want to cry about dad, but you need him. I grew up so fucked, but I didn't even deep it. I'm numb to the feeling of grieving. A man getting birded. African mums on the floor just screaming. It's mad car, try so hard. Death's got to be easy because life's so hard. I was 12 wishing that I was a white man Harker. If I was, then he probably wouldn't life man's dogs. I was dead broke, fam. I couldn't swipe man's card. And time might pass, but I still gotta stay with it. It wasn't his beef, but I see him try claiming it. That's why he caught a bullet with another man's name on it. Now we can't do leg day or put strain on it. Every time you hear me freestyle, I'll put pain in it. I used to wonder, does God have favorites? Touch me, it's dangerous. I wouldn't play with it, cause you can go sleep and have a different type of wake for it. I miss my dogs. Unstable, you violate Kristen Rod.
Yeah, we gotta do it. He said, touch me is dangerous because you can go to sleep and have a different type of wake for it.
Yeah, bro. Right? You know, because when you go to sleep, you wake up in the morning. But when you die, they have a wake for your death, right? You're going to be at your wake. That's the way you're going to wake up.
Playing with him. Touching him is dangerous, he said, right?
Yeah,
I wouldn't play with it.
But
so,
but I love it though, man. This whole scheme that he's in, because before that he said, I used to wonder, does God have favorites, you know? And dude, I used to wonder that when I was a kid, because when you see messed up things that happen, you know, no matter, you know, where you grow up, I mean, we all have different struggles. You wonder that sometimes,
yeah.
Like, man, is there, I need to be on the favorite list. So whatever whatever that person is doing, I need to be doing that. If God have faith, has favorites. But
right.
the way he played that into this whole scheme, I thought was beautiful. And the way I'm taking this whole scheme that he's in right now is his personal struggle. You know what I'm saying? With talking about his girlfriend, her dad used to beat her, and you know, and his struggle with that. Like, if I don't do shit, then I feel like less than a man, but it's her dad. So there's a struggle there. And then his mom's struggle of working and stuff like that. And yep. I think he said something about peeing on a seat, right? Because and having your mom clean it. And that affected the way I see shit, nightclub, toilet, and you peed on the seat. Because you don't know how it feels when your mom's got to clean shit. And you're not really part of the, like, solution. You're part of the problem, so to speak. And I just think it's a lack of respect is what he's saying for the trials and tribulations that people care about you go through. And it's just disrespectful. Like, you peeing on the seat. Like, you're spitting in my face, so to speak.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
I just think that this is a very vulnerable and very true and very real.
Very introspective, for sure.
For him. You know?
Yep. Yep, and that line as well, I think, as well, is just sort of, he's speaking to when you're at a nightclub and motherfuckers is peeing on a toilet, man. These people, it's different when you come from struggle and you see the struggle,
right?
And you see it and you feel it and you're going through it. You don't know what that's like, you know what I mean? So it's easy for you to just dismiss and pee on a seat, and that's somebody's mom, he said, right?
Yep, that's true.
He said that's someone's mother that has to clean that up, and you're just being disrespectful. But just in a nutshell, man, Dave, I think one of the big things that people love about Dave is not only the fact that he's real and he bears a soul, but he seems to be very selfless. You know what I'm saying? Like, he seems to care about the world. He's compassionate, compare about people outside of himself. And I think that's being shown in this song about his girl's abusive dad and, you know, chastising people for being disrespectful and peeing on toilet seats in a nightclub may seem minuscule to you.
And you one know? And Go one ahead. Thing I want to touch real quick. I know this shit is long, but one thing I want to touch before we move on is he said, how many of our parents had dreams that they abandoned just so they could put food on the table? That is such a true statement.
Very true.
How many people can relate to that?
Yep.
You know what I mean? Because a lot of people, when you've got to put food on the table for your family, I would love to do this. I would love to do that. But all that shit takes the back seat.
Yeah.
Right?
So the ultimate sacrifice, you know? And it kind of ties into what he said earlier about, you know, the Somali dad that's leaving his country for war just to try to, you know, to put his family in a better situation, right, for survival. And then next thing you know, his kids are getting into the streets, and it's just, and he's all tying that in, man. I think there's a lack of respect and appreciation from this generation, and maybe he's even holding himself accountable to a degree as well. Mm-hmm. So the selflessness of Dave is what I'm really impressed with throughout this song. But let's keep it going, man.
It's dangerous. I wouldn't play with it because you can go sleep and have a different type of wake for it. I miss my dogs. Unstable, you violate Chris Denra. Turn Chris Benoit. Have him hit from far now. Fill him up with bricks and glass. Now my young G's will grip them blast. Have you tried in the street? Fuck finding my feet. I could ride, but it's better when I'm riding a beat. My emotions are peak. It ain't a sign of defeat. All the week I wouldn't see him chewed and cried in my sleep. Dropped just 2 racks and told him buy the machine. I'm LeBron in Miami. I provide for the heat. God strike me if I'm lying. I ain't crying in this beef unless the tears coming tatted on the side of my cheek. I provide for my peeps, the lamb white in the seat, so I'm literally a wolf disguised in a sheep.
Yeah, he's bad. Yeah. Dreams, I have to stop it yet again. Yeah, it's too much. I tried to let him ride though. But he was barring us to death, man. I mean, what lines do you want to touch here? You know what I mean? God strike me if I'm lying. I ain't crying in this beef unless the tears is coming tatted on the side of my cheek.
I'm putting in work.
So, you know, anyone who knows about tatted tears, it means that it's a sort of it signifies that you've put in work. That's, you know, you've caught bodies, if you want to keep it real. So when we beefing, there ain't no crying. It's just a tear that shows that you caught the bad end of the stick in this beef. You know what I'm saying?
I'm like LeBron in Miami. I'm providing the heat, baby.
I provide for the heat.
Yeah, dude.
Hard.
Yeah, man.
LeBron played for the Miami Heat basketball team, but he's talking about a gun. He provides the money for the gun.
Yep.
You know, to put the work in. The machine is what he said.
Yeah.
So, I mean, but just the way he said all this as well. Go ahead, Ryan.
And the way he's riding it, too.
Yeah,
dude.
Man.
And I love the way he said that I'm literally a wolf disguised in a sheep.
That
was
so crazy.
Because he's talking grimy. He's talking about all the things that make up the crime and the bad shit in London, right? He's kind of giving you a peek inside the mind of someone like this, right? And inside this world. So he's disguised, right? You know, because he's providing the heat. You know, he's got a tear. He's like, I don't cry, you know, unless the tears are tatted on the side of my cheek. Nice. That just means that you killed someone here. I would assume that that means the same thing there. Mm-hmm. So you've got a lot of things in your past that maybe you're not proud of, but you're a beast. The way I'm defining that line, that wolf disguised in a sheep, you're a beast. Don't get it twisted. Don't get this nice, I'm a rappy guy, you know, I'm doing songs and making money and shit. Don't get me wrong. I've done my dirt too, you know?
And I still will do dirt if it came to it, is what it sounds like. As well, I still will get busy if it came to it. But that line, though, man, let's dig into that line. I provide for my peeps the lamb white in the seats. So I'm literally a wolf disguised in a sheep. So the Lamborghini, I think, is what he's saying. The lamb as in the car, yep. Right? But he's also playing on a wolf in sheep's clothing. You know what I'm saying? So the lamb in the white seat. So I'm literally a wolf disguised in a sheep. Like I'm a fucking beast, like you said, on some thug shit.
Yep.
And I'm in my Lamborghini. You know what I'm saying? But I'm a wolf in a Lamborghini. So real, real slick play on words there,
don't
man.
Don't let the Lamborghini fool you.
No, don't let that fool you. But even this right here, my young G's will grip thin blast. Have them tried in the street. Fuck fine in my feet. I could ride, but it's better when I'm riding the beat. You know what I'm saying? So to me, I take that line probably a different way. I don't know if he means it this way. I mean, he can ride on them. I can be in the field with my soldiers and ride on them and put the work in myself. But I'm the boss, man. I'm you know, I provide for the heat, man. You know what I'm saying? I let my young G's do all that. And I'm in the studio riding a beat while I'm getting you touched. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Is what he could be saying by that. But that was just the whole, not only just what he said, but just the way that he got into this mode, the mode that he was in right here. Was just raw.
Yeah, it was.
Beefing, and I ain't into speaking. When I ducked down, I had him running in a lift like he missed a meeting. There's no good reason to risk your freedom. The youths, them snitching and bitches sneaking. She don't want to talk about friendship. She just want to deal with a pipe like I'm fixing leaking. And sleep with a legend like Chrissy Teigen. Where I'm from, the word life has a different meaning. Man, smile in your face, but them niggas scheming. Try involve me in a flaky dealing. Sistine Chapel, I'ma paint the ceiling. I've been violated and I hate the feeling. That's why nowadays man hates the preaching. We smile in a visit cause we ain't defeated. The Supreme Court's and my mates appealing. I can't breathe that girl, that's torture. South London is just slags on a corner and influencers trying to bag them a baller.
But Dave is bitter though. You know, like he said. Dave,
I didn't think you were going to say that.
Yeah, Dave's a little bitter though. But you know, he's saying I've been violated. Right? And I hate the feeling. So when he said, I've been violating, I hate the feeling, I think about all the other things that he's saying. He's talking about the women that he's dealt with. Mm-hmm. You know, it just seems like he's had bad experiences. When he's talking about, even in the other song, I made a couple jokes about, you know, Dave just like pushes vagina away and shit. You know, I just think that he's been so used to dealing with, you know, women who have been opportunists and trying to take advantage of him. And this is kind of what he sees, right? This is what he's looking out for. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Almost like he's sort of overcompensating in a way because of some of the bad experiences that he's ran into with some of the women that's probably in the field that he's in, right? Being a famous rapper. I like this line right here when he said, my OG's is Roman, I don't need a Coliseum. My OG's Roman, I don't need a call to see him, is what I think that he's saying. That's the line. You know, they out here. My OG's is out here. They good. They're fine, man. I mean, they roaming around here. They're not locked down. I got them taken care of. I don't need to call them why they jammed up in prison. Right. You know what I'm saying? I got them taken care of. So I thought that was a slick, the wordplay in that was slick. But again, just talking about the, you know, fuck the internet. He's talking about fuck the internet. You see this new generation of Insta beefing. I ain't into speaking. And he's talking about the girls, the youths, the bitches are sneaking. Yeah. She don't want to talk about friendship. She just want to deal with the pipe like I'm fixing leaking and sleep with a legend like Chrissy Teigen. You know, so he's talking about John Legend, the singer John Legend. His wife is Chrissy Teigen, but he's the legend. She just want to sleep with a legend like Chrissy Teigen. So slick wordplay.
Yeah, it is.
But I think it's rooted in him being a bit jaded and bitter. This new generation just kind of, to me, is just sort of uncovering all that's wrong with the new generation. Fuck the internet. You know, these girls just want to be a baller. They just want to be an influencer and get all the ballers. They're not about anything. There's no substance.
Yep.
So that's just the feeling I get. You know, he's just on guard, too. He's like, you know what I'm saying? Every time it's like you touch me at Chris Benoit. Fuck you talking about? You know what I'm saying? What do you say? Sistine Chapel. Yeah. What? I paint the ceilings.
Boy. Yeah.
Fuck you talking about? See, that's what Dave is on. But he's a jaded sort of, it's bitterness and he's jaded and. You know, also wisdom. You know what I mean? He's learned a lot, but it just seems rooted in just, you know, anger and bitterness to me as well. Like, it just feels that way to me.
All right, man, let's get back to it.
Keep dealing. Sistine Chapel, I'ma paint the ceiling. I've been violated and I hate the feeling. That's why nowadays man hates the preaching. We smile in a visit cause we ain't defeated. The Supreme Court's my mates appealing. I can't breathe that girl, that's torture. South London is just slags in a corner and influencers trying to bag them a baller. She a gold digger, I can tell from her aura. Her socials say princess, she a pauper. When it's time for it, need more for my daughter. Call me a talker, but man are getting lined like lambs in a slaughter. It's life threatening and I can tell from the borer. Cut through a nigga like a knife through flora. Feds got the guys on a case and they stalk us. It's a conspiracy like tinfoil hats in a new world order. Touch me, you better have a life insurer. Bloodthirsty, I got sharks in the water. And trust me, I know a killer well, no orca. Yeah. Have you ever seen a nightmare?
I'm done. Touch me, man. I know a killer well.
Yeah.
No orca. I know them killers very well. If you touch me, I know some guys that'll do something to you. I know them very well. Killer well is an orca. Orcas are called killer whales. But yeah, I know a killer like, well.
I tear him up, you know. But I hear you, though, man, because he's definitely rapping like he's had some experience with some, you know.
He said he's been violent. Yeah. And he ain't like the feeling. And he's like, never again, bro.
Fed's got the guys on a case and they stalk us. It's a conspiracy like tinfoil hats in a new world order. Touch me, you better have a life insurer. Bloodthirsty, I got sharks in the water. And trust me, I know a killer well, no orca. Have you ever seen a nightmare brought to life? Where I'm from, you get chefed on a normal night. Man talk on my name, but it's porcupines. I really put it in a prick like a porcupine. Little bro wanna save for a 45. Go board a flight, there's more to life. Utes on the M6 all the time. We don't need TFL for a northern line. All the best politicians been taught to lie. Where do they buy cocaine when they're snorting white? Are their dealers safe or on the borderline? It's ironic, cause we don't know where to draw the line. Man see blue story, they're mortified. Man see Scarface and it's glorified.
Yeah,
cause when you're black, everything gets scrutinized. That's why they call it urban, it gets euphemized. South London, man are getting euphonized. I see a huge demise. I wasn't too surprised.
Yeah,
he got
soaked,
but his right hand scooping.
Y'all right, man. Y'all were right.
Yeah, yeah, he killing it.
Y'all were right.
This is
the Dave I wanted to see. I'm sorry, you know? Like, the beat was cool in the other one, but we talk about art and creating just greatness. This is what it is right here, man. This might be the best I've ever heard from Dave. I'm going to keep it real.
Saying when you black, everything gets scrutinized. That's why they call it urban.
It gets euphemized.
Damn.
And
yeah,
they said they're getting euthanized.
Yeah.
And boy. Shit.
Yeah, man. He's definitely in his bag right now. Yeah, he's not pulling any punches, man.
Mm-mm.
He's laying it all out there, man. Men see blue story and it's mortified. And he said, man see Scarface and it's glorified. I think he's right? Everything is ass backwards. I don't know what Blue Story is, but I know Scarface is about a drug king that everyone loved that movie. I'm like the odd man out in that. Everyone was like, oh man, you got to see Scarface. Scarface is so incredible. When I finally saw it, I'm like, yes, it's about a drug dealer. He built a drug empire and he killed a lot of people and he went out in a blaze and he died at the end of the movie. But they're like, the way he died was off the chain. That's you. I can see you smiling. Because
Al Pacino. No.
Okay, say hello to my little friend. I'm like, I don't see
legendary.
What, I don't see what's so great about that, though.
He was just an amazing. His acting in that. To me, what makes Scarface great is just Al Pacino.
Okay.
Not the script.
Not the script. And
Al Pacino was phenomenal in that. That's all I know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I know Cubans. You know, so I'm from the East Coast. I know dudes and Cubans, Dominicans that looked at that shit like, is he Cuban?
He played the part well.
But I get your point, though. I get kind of where you're going. They're trying to glorify, you know, in Blue Story, I don't know if it's, you know, because we could put it together. It's pretty clear as day is what he's trying to say, because he then followed it up by saying, because when you're black, everything gets scrutinized, and that's why they call it urban. It gets euphemized. So mm-hmm. I can only assume that Blue is maybe a black story of some sort. I got to give us some feedback
like
on Blue Story.
It's like a New Jack City.
Probably. A story about black kids in London or some shit. Something like that. Some hood shit probably in London. It's probably what that's about.
Mm-hmm.
But that was like mortifying to people. But when those same people would look at Scarface and look at it as art and beautiful and, it's glorified, right?
Especially if that story is about a drug lord as well.
Yes.
Then that brings that line to life. I don't know, but if that's
or even involving drug, you know, you're saying involving that activity in any way, yeah, man.
If anybody black is doing it, they're selling drugs. Yeah. Oh, that's horrible. We don't want to talk about that. But right. Scarface, that was off the chain.
Yep. Yep. That's exactly what he's saying.
How ridiculous does that sound? Yep. You know, if it's the same thing.
Yep. And when he said that's why they call it urban, it gets urban, right? With quotations, it gets euphemized, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's looked at, you know, when you say euphemized, man, it's looked at as something, it's this sort of
negative
that they attach mm-hmm. to it to kind of diminish it in some way to make it look less than or unpleasant when they say urban radio sometimes. I mean, you can apply that to a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking for a way to sort of segregate it from something else.
Diminish it.
To make it look less than.
Yeah.
You know, so again, we're tying it into the whole Scarface Blue Story thing. It ties right into that. But just this bag he got into, even flow-wise. South London, man, are getting euthanized. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They're getting killed. I see a youth's demise. I see a youth's, in America, mm-hmm. demise. I wasn't mm-hmm. too surprised. He got soaked. Mm-hmm. But his right-hand scuba dive? And then I don't know if we got to this part, but I'm reading ahead. Don't die by a sword that you used to shine?
Mm-hmm.
That line is crazy.
Yeah, man.
Wow. What's the old saying? You live by the sword. You die by the sword. Yep. Right? You know what I'm saying?
But I mean, you could take that in so many different directions. I don't want to like make the video even longer. But the way I'm taking that is, dude, like what you idolize and what you use to get your fame, you died by that as well.
That's
you
right.
You know what I mean? That could be drugs. That could be killing people. That could be a slew of different things, you know.
That's
but
right.
That is a hard, hard line, dude.
That's what I'm saying. And it's a cautionary tale as well, mm-hmm. right? You know, it's almost he's just giving advice to the youth. You know, what I mean, the youth are getting killed,
yeah,
right? Dude. They're getting euthanized out here, man. Don't die by. And he said up top here, he said, "Little bro, want to save for 45? Go board a flight. There's more to life."
Yeah.
So he's talking to the youth here
yep.
and saying, dude, there's more to life than being in the streets and killing each other
exactly.
and getting killed. So don't die by a sword that you used to shine.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
You're
in the street with guns of knives or whatever, like Ryan said.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you live by that, you die by that.
Yep.
So just get out of it. You know what I mean? Live your life. So this is very, very dope, man, by Dave, man. But that he got soaked by his right hand,
yeah.
but his right hand scuba dive. I'm not sure exactly what, I know he got soaked up, he got wet with bullets, he got
yeah.
killed.
Yeah.
I don't know if he meant, went by right hand scuba dive. That's a weird, weird line to me.
Yeah.
Scuba dived as in like he was soaked up, so he drowned. Like
yeah.
he drowned from the bullets and shit is what how I'm taking that. But yeah. just fire though,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, dude.
It's ironic, cause we don't know where to draw the line. Men see Blue Story, they're mortified. Men see Scarface and it's glorified. Cause when you're black, everything gets scrutinized. That's why they call it urban, it gets euphemized. South London, man are getting euthanized. I see a youth's demise, I wasn't too surprised. He got soaked, but his right hand scuba dived. Don't die by a sword that you used to shine. You can drown for your king. We don't know about Ophelia, cause we got iron. I don't know about anemia, I took the hard road. We don't know about the easier, one bag of whores and drug paraphernalia. When ends got sticky, had a flicky with Amelia. I mean Olivia, this ain't Libya, this ain't Syria. You act sillier, we let it seep in your skin like Nivea. Mm-hmm. Who wants to be a millionaire? I won it, never done a game show or trivia. I done Wandsworth, Elstoke Visitor. I done Spring Hill, Grendon, Swinford, Whitemore, Swellside, Brixton Visitor. I done M-Way trips, done shit that I wish I never did, because I could have been a prisoner. Is this the shit that appeals to the listeners? Road ain't no amazing life. The end's full of snakes and jail's just a waste of time. I told my young G's, take your time. Fuck jazz, you could really see a major nine.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, I'm so ashamed of how I used to get figures. Man, sell you a dream like the road thing's lit, and then they leave out the parts where you're burying your niggas or in jail, wondering who's putting dick inside your missus. I'm so fucking determined. I was in intensive
There's
care when I was
nuts,
born.
Man.
Mummy fell down the stairs. Whether I was gonna live or not was something uncertain. I used the word fell with the commas inverted. You see, growing up, I had it far from perfect. But nobody did, so I'm a normal person. I gotta be grateful. We all have demons and all see angels. Or maybe it's me. A black youth's more than a face on a screen. A number on a laptop or name on a sheet. We got stories to tell and got places to be. From a heart that's the making of me.
Yeah.
I was sending you. I was sending you. I struggled because I didn't want to suffer again. I just wanted. You just make me so upset.
Go ahead and end it there.
Yeah, it's enough sadness, you know?
Yeah.
We get the point. The shit's bad. Dude, before I give like my conclusion here, man, real quick, this was great.
Excellent.
He really put his heart to paper.
His heart into it.
Heart. heart attack, right?
He attacked our hearts.
Yeah, dude. I'm glad that you guys recommended this to us because I see why. He really put it all out in this song, man. And bravo. Bravo. Seriously. Yes, I mean, I think he really destroyed this, man.
This might be the, like I was saying in this might be the best I personally have ever heard from Dave. This was just, this might be his magnum opus right here, man. When it's all said and done, when people look at his career, or at least it's going to be one of them. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I guess you can only have one magnum opus. But it'll be one of the greatest pieces of work that that he's ever done, man.
Yeah,
you know what
dude.
I mean? This is what it's about. You know, I love when people talk about the streets, man. You know, when I look at hip hop, I think hip hop has kind of gotten to a point where there's a bunch of gun bars and lines about shooting and killing people with no direction, no story, no substance, no real rhyme or reason for it. It's just because it sounds cool to people. And there's a glorification of it. And I'm not saying that one thing, I think there's a misconception, like there is glory in the streets. You know what I mean? Drug dealers do see a certain level of glory. That's just real.
There is
street glory. But I think what's missing in a lot of rappers today, man, when they're talking and they had these little gun bars and shit, is the other side of it, man. Is the other side. No, this isn't all glitz and glamour. It's not just cool.
Yeah.
This is what comes with it. This comes with the life. He said a lot in here about that. An example here is when he said, I done M-way trips, done shit that I wish I never did because I could have been a prisoner. Is this the shit that appeals to the listeners? Road ain't no amazing life. The end's full of snakes and jails. Just a waste of time. I told my young G's, take your time. You know what I'm saying? Then he followed it up with fuck jazz. You can really see a major.
Major nine, yep.
You know what I'm saying? But nine major, which is a note or whatever in jazz, right? But nine years is how I'm taking it. You know what I'm saying? But
Major nine.
You know?
Yeah.
You almost see a dime is what we call it. Almost see 10 years do a dime. Man.
Yeah.
So I think lines like that are what tell me that Dave is, you know, although he talks about the streets and this and that because he grew up in it and, you know, he just respect is just zero tolerance for disrespect and we will handle things accordingly if it needs to go there. I don't want to glorify it either.
Yep.
These are the consequences that come with it. And he's telling you the peaks and valleys, the ups and downs, and he's giving you the full picture when he's talking about it, which I think is great. And I don't really see him necessarily trying to glorify it that much, you know what I mean? Which I think is very impressive, which I think is also very important when you're trying to look at something as an artistic piece and not just a bunch of dudes talking about guns aimlessly without any direction, man. And he put his heart into it, right? There's a heart attack. There's anxiety that comes with this type of lifestyle that can give you a heart attack. And I think it attacks, this type of shit pulls on your heartstrings. Mm-hmm. It attacks your heart. So there's no way we can be able to do this justice in just one quick reaction like this. There's no way. You know what I mean? This is we need three videos at least to really delve into this the way I think it needs.
Yeah.
But I thought that this was great, man. Salute to Dave.
It was, dude. Dope. Super dope.
Okay, man, maybe we can trust Shaw now, man. Because I was going to say, I told Ryan, I was just like, man, you do 9 minutes and this is all right, man. After 9 minutes, man, I don't know, man. Never again, man.
At the pool of UK car. And I'm joking.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Salute to everybody that requested
this
in the comments and blew us the fuck up. And that's it, man. That's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm George. That's Ryan, Lost in Vegas.
We out.
We out.